Bonjour and welcome, viewers and students, to Let's Speak French, Parlons Français. These lessons on basic French are short and easy. And if you follow the program regularly, I can assure you that very soon you will be able to understand French quite easily. The previous session focused on the present tense of RE ending verbs. In today's class, we will focus on the present tense conjugation of reflexive verbs. This lesson has been divided into three sections. In this first section, I will read out a French text that consists of many different reflexive verbs. Then in the next section, I will explain what reflexive verbs are and how they are conjugated in the present tense. And finally, in the third section, we will do an exercise to revise what we learned in today's session. We'll begin the lesson with a French text. This text consists of a dialogue that takes place in a classroom between the teacher and the students. The teacher asks the students questions regarding their daily routine. Les habitudes quotidiennes. L'institutrice. Bonjour la classe. Aujourd'hui, je vous pose des questions sur vos habitudes quotidiennes. J'interroge seulement ceux qui se tiennent tranquilles. Florent, tu te lèves à quelle heure?
Je me lève à 7 heures, madame.
Et ensuite, qu'est-ce que tu fais?
Je me douche et je m'habille.
Tu ne te brosses pas les dents?
Si, madame, je me brosse les dents chaque jour.
Tu te rases la barbe aussi?
Non, madame, je ne me rase pas. Je n'ai pas de barbe. Mais mon père, il se rase tous les matins.
Merci, Florent, tu peux t'asseoir.
Voyons qui sera la prochaine.
À toi, Mathilde. En général, qu'est-ce que tu fais le soir?
Ma cousine et moi, on se rencontre et on se promène dans le parc.
Et ensuite?
Je rentre chez moi, je me déshabille et je me lave. À 8 heures, on prend le dîner. Parfois, ma sœur se met au piano et nous nous amusons beaucoup.
Vous vous couchez quand?
Je me couche vers 9 heures. Mais ma sœur s'en va chez des amis et rentre tard. Je crois qu'elle dort après minuit, car elle ne peut jamais se réveiller tôt.
Merci, Mathilde. So this was a short text with plenty of reflexive verbs. In the next section, I will show you how to conjugate reflexive verbs in the present tense. In the French language, there is a particular type of verb that is known as les verbes pronominaux or pronominal verbs in English. Pronominal verbs are those whose direct object is the same as their subject. In English, verbs that are immediately followed by the term myself, herself, ourselves, etc. are known as pronominal verbs because the subject performs the action on himself. Let me give you a few examples of pronominal verbs in English. I enjoyed myself yesterday. You blame yourself for what happened. They hurt themselves while playing. The infinitive form of these three pronominal verbs are to enjoy oneself, to blame oneself, and to hurt oneself. In French, it's the addition of a reflexive pronoun that characterizes a pronominal verb. In the conjugation of a regular verb, one finds two elements. A subject pronoun, je, tu, il, elle, nous, vous, il, elle, and the verb. For example, in the French sentence,
Je regarde un film, which means I'm watching a film. Je is the subject pronoun, while regarde is the verb. Un film is the direct object of the verb. But in the conjugation of a pronominal verb, one finds three elements: a subject pronoun, a reflexive pronoun, and the verb. Let's look at an example with the same verb. Je me regarde dans la glace. I'm watching myself in the mirror. In the French sentence, je is again the subject pronoun, while regarde is the verb. What is different, however, is the direct object of the verb. Me, which is the direct object in this sentence, is the same as the subject je. So, in other words, one can say that the subject of the verb is performing the action of watching on himself. In the French language, reflexive pronouns have just one function. Reflexive verbs are a special type of pronouns that are used only with pronominal verbs and always function as the direct object of the pronominal verb. There are five reflexive pronouns in French: me, te, se, nous, and vous. Each one of these reflexive pronoun agrees with the subject pronoun they accompany. In other words, in the conjugation of a pronominal verb, the subject pronoun always appears with its corresponding reflexive pronoun. This table displays the eight subject pronouns and their corresponding reflexive pronouns. Je corresponds to me, tu, te, il, se, elle, se, nous, nous, vous, vous, il se, elle se. In French, pronominal verbs are always identified by the reflexive pronoun se that precedes the verb in its infinitive form. It's easy to identify the pronominal verb when it is in its infinitive form. But when the pronominal verb is conjugated and used in a sentence, one may tend to overlook the reflexive pronoun. In the example, je me regarde dans la glace, the verb is not regarde but me regarde, which is the first person singular form of the pronominal verb se regarder. When conjugating a pronominal verb, one must always remember that the reflexive pronoun changes according to the subject of the verb. Je me regarde dans la glace becomes tu te regardes dans la glace and nous nous regardons dans la glace. As you can see, the reflexive pronoun alters with the subject tu te, nous nous. If the verb begins with a vowel, the phenomenon of elision must be observed. The letter E from the reflexive pronoun is replaced by an apostrophe. M apostrophe, T apostrophe, S apostrophe, S apostrophe, nous, vous, S apostrophe, and again S apostrophe. As for the conjugation of the verb, one conjugates the pronominal verb exactly as one would conjugate its so-called corresponding regular verb. For example, the pronominal verb se regarder corresponds to the regular verb regarder. And since regarder belongs to the first group, se regarder also belongs to the same group. One must not assume that every pronominal verb has a corresponding regular verb. The majority of pronominal verbs have a non-reflexive use as well. And when it does, the regular verb may have a different meaning from its so-called corresponding pronominal verb. For example, entendre means to listen, but s'entendre means to understand one another. Similarly, appeler means to call someone, but s'appeler means to be named.
Now that you know what a pronominal verb is and what is the function of a reflexive pronoun, let me explain to you what a reflexive verb is. There are three types of pronominal verbs in the French language: reflexive verbs, reciprocal verbs, and idiomatic pronominal verbs. Reflexive verbs are the most common type of pronominal verbs. In reflexive verbs, the subject of the verb performs the action upon himself, herself, or itself. Most reflexive verbs are related to actions that have to do with clothing, body parts, personal circumstances, or locations. Here are some common reflexive verbs. A few of them are used in the text as well: s'approcher de, to approach; s'asseoir, to sit; s'habiller, to get dressed; se souvenir, to remember; se laver les mains, la figure, to wash one's hands, one's face. Let me conjugate three of these verbs in the present tense to show you how reflexive verbs are conjugated. S'asseoir, to sit. Je m'assois. Tu t'assois. Il s'assoit. Elle s'assoit. Nous nous asseyons. Vous vous asseyez. Il s'assoit. Elle s'assoit. Se laver. To wash oneself. Je me lave. Tu te laves. Il se lave. Elle se lave. Nous nous lavons. Vous vous lavez. Il se lave. Elle se lave. Se souvenir, to remember. Je me souviens. Tu te souviens. Il se souvient. Elle se souvient. Nous nous souvenons. Vous vous souvenez. Ils se souviennent and elles se souviennent. As you can see, the conjugation pattern is identical to the regular corresponding verbs. What differs is the addition of the reflexive pronouns. In the French text I just read out, most of the verbs are reflexive verbs. Let me list them out. Tu te lèves, je me lève, se lever, to wake up. Je me douche, se doucher, to have a shower. Tu te brosses, je me brosse, se brosser, to brush one's teeth or one's hair. Je m'habille, s'habiller, to dress up. Tu te rases, je me rase, il se rase, to shave. Tu t'assois, s'asseoir, to sit. On se promène, se promener, to take a walk. Je me déshabille, se déshabiller, to undress. Je me lave, se laver, to wash oneself. Nous nous amusons, s'amuser, to enjoy oneself. Vous vous couchez, je me couche, se coucher, to go to bed. Elle se réveille, se réveiller, to wake up. All these 14 verbs are reflexive verbs because the subject is the same as the direct object. In other words, the subject doing the action performs them on himself. Now let's quickly look at the other two lesser known pronominal verbs. While reflexive verbs indicate how the subject or subjects act upon themselves, reciprocal verbs are those that indicate two or more persons acting on one another. The most common reciprocal verbs are s'aimer, to love one another; se connaître, to know one another; se disputer, to argue; and s'écrire, to write to one another. In the text, there is just one reciprocal verb, se rencontrer, which means
to meet one another. The third type of pronominal verbs is idiomatic reflexive verbs. This type of pronominal verbs are those that are generally followed by a preposition. Moreover, their meanings change when the reflexive pronouns are omitted. In other words, the meanings of the two corresponding verbs, one regular and one pronominal, are different. In the French text, we have three examples of idiomatic reflexive verbs. J'interroge ceux qui se tiennent tranquilles. I will question those who behave themselves. Ma sœur se met au piano. My sister sits at the piano. Ma sœur s'en va chez des amis. My sister goes to her friend's house. Se met is the third person singular form of the verb se mettre, which means to sit or to be located. In its non-reflexive usage, the verb mettre means to place. As for the pronominal verbs s'en va, its infinitive form is s'en aller, which translates as to go away. Aller, as we know by now, means to go. So these were the three types of pronominal verbs in the French language. Although strictly speaking there exists a difference between them, in reality one hardly ever thinks about these distinctions. In fact, the majority of speakers are unaware of the three types of pronominal verbs. So to summarize, pronominal verbs are characterized by their reflexive pronouns. The pronoun always agrees with the subject and functions as the direct object of the verb. As for the conjugation of the pronominal verbs, the verb without its reflexive pronoun is conjugated in the exact way as its corresponding regular verb. Before we proceed to the revision, let me illustrate how reflexive verbs are used in the negative form. Je ne me lave pas les mains. Elle ne se brosse pas les dents. As you can see, it's the entire verb, that is the verb and the reflexive pronoun, that are placed between the negative word pair. In this third section, we will revise what we learned in today's session on pronominal verbs. A short exercise has been provided below. We need to complete the six sentences by conjugating the pronominal verb within brackets. Mes frères se disputaient souvent. This sentence translates as, my brothers argue often with each other. If we consider the corresponding non-reflexive verb, we find that disputer, which means to quarrel about something, is the first group verb. Hence, se disputer too belongs to the first group. Thus, the right conjugated form is mes frères se disputent souvent. Le malade ne se nourrit presque plus. This sentence translates as the patient has almost stopped eating. If we consider the corresponding non-reflexive verb, we find that nourrir, which means to feed, is a second group verb. Hence, se nourrir too belongs to the second group. Thus, the right conjugated form is le malade ne se nourrit presque plus. Comment tu s'appelles? This sentence translates as what's your name? If we consider the corresponding non-reflexive verb, we find that appeler, which means to call, is a first group verb. Hence, s'appeler too belongs to the first group. Thus, the right conjugated form is comment tu t'appelles? Nous s'inscrire à un cours de salsa. This sentence translates as we register ourselves for a salsa course. If we consider the corresponding non-reflexive verb, we find that inscrire, which means to subscribe or to register,
is the third group verb. Hence, Sanskrit too belongs to the third group. Thus, the right conjugated form is Nous nous inscrivons à un cours de salsa. Je s'habillais pour le dîner. This sentence translates as I get dressed for the evening. If we consider the corresponding non-reflexive verb, we find that habiller, which means to dress, is a first group verb. Hence, s'habiller too belongs to the first group. Thus, the right conjugated form is Je m'habille pour le dîner. Est-ce que vous se connaître? This sentence translates as Do you know each other? If we consider the corresponding non-reflexive verb, we find that connaître, which means to know, is a third group verb. Hence, se connaître too belongs to the third group. Thus, the right conjugated form is Est-ce que vous vous connaissez? With this, we come to the end of our fourth lesson. This lesson was divided into three sections. In the first section, I read out a French text that consists of many different reflexive verbs. In the second section, I explained what reflexive verbs are and how they are conjugated in the present tense. And finally, in the third section, we revised today's lesson by doing an exercise on French pronominal verbs. I hope you enjoyed today's session. In the next class, we'll learn about the third group verbs. I hope to see you in the next class. Thank you and à bientôt. See you soon.